Good day, it's Tony Fortunato from the Technology Firm. I'm just whipping up a really quick video because it's a byproduct of an article I'm working on. I thought this was very interesting and that you might want to know about this. So just it's a real quick video. Here's my little lab. I got two laptops, right? Connected to a switch, gig, real simple stuff. And I'm playing with good old iPerf, so I'm generating a lot of traffic. So as you can see, it's a 10-second test and it sent a ton of data, over a gigabytes. Right, gigabytes of data, and that was 929 megabits per second. So that being said, so there's a lot of stuff. So I'm using Wireshark because I'm baselining the app. I want to see how it behaves, all that kind of good stuff. And I noticed something interesting with Wireshark. So when I sent all this data, I assumed with that much data hitting my machine, since Wireshark is software-based, running on WinPCAP and all that kind of nonsense, I assumed I would have lost some packets. That's what I thought. So I went, checked here at the bottom. It just says packets displayed in previous versions of Wireshark. I'm just going to drag this out to show you there's nothing else here. It usually had a discards or dropped, right? The terminology, I think it was dropped actually, not discards. So there was another counter here, and it's not there, so I just assumed, wait a minute. It should have dropped something. I know it should have, because I know my machine. So if I go up to statistics and I go to capture file properties, let me just bring that down here for you. If you pay attention, it's right there, dropped packets. And there it is, 603,724. So this, it's missing from here, but now it's in here under capture file properties. So whenever you do a test, whenever you capture packets, we used to just see it at the bottom of the status bar. It's no longer there. So now it's under capture file properties. All right, there you go. Just 2-minute tip. Have a good day. Bye for now.